This is video number 3 out of the series The Blueprint for a Successful Business Makeover, which helps business owners grow to their full potential. It's a series of 8, and this is about branding. Chapter number 3 of The Blueprint for a Successful Business Makeover. 8 steps that every business owner should know to grow to the full business potential. And this is not only about the business, this is about you being the business owner too. So how do you know what your personal, do you know your personal identity? And do you know your business identity? Do you know what your personal brand is? I mean, you might not like it, but you are a personal brand because people have an opinion about you. And maybe it's wise that you determine what kind of opinion they have of you, because this is something what you can predict, and that's personal branding. And how do you brand your business? What is the identity of your business, and how do you want to have your clients look at your business? How do you want to have future clients look at your business? What do you want them to feel about your business? What do you want them to think? How can they identify themselves with you or your business? A lot of business owners are not aware of this, and it's very, very important. And do you even know who your ideal client is? Or is just anybody who's paying your ideal client? And do you have the guts to send your clients home because they do not fit your ideal client profile? And this is something very weird. If people are knocking at your door and they want to pay you money because they want to be your client, but they don't fit your client profile. And this is like cursing in the church. It's something unheard of for most entrepreneurs. But I can guarantee you, if you have an ideal client profile and you know exactly who your clients are, your communication is very easy because you know exactly what they think, what they feel, how they will react. It's so much easier for you to sell. It's so much easier for your clients to buy from you because they feel heard, they feel recognized, they feel seen, they like you, they want to do business with you. And I'm not saying the client who doesn't fit your ideal profile that you should refuse them, but it's some sort of advice though, because often those are the clients which are going to cause you trouble or will cost you a lot of time or are not happy with your service or your product, and they complain or moan or whinge. Now there's a lot of personal branding tools. For example, things that you could do as the business owner to attract attention on you as the business owner. Speaking, creating videos, being in a panel as an expert. And also, what kind of clothing do you wear? What kind of image do you create of yourself? And there's various other things. And what's very important is, what kind of testimonials do you have? Because you can have testimonials of all the clients that are happy with you, but do they fit your ideal client profile? Do the testimonials say, what was it like before they met you? And what happened when they met you? How are they now after they've been with you or after they bought your product? What does it do? And often testimonials are not written right, and then they don't sell. Then there's no point. If they say, oh, she's very nice, or she did a good service. Yeah, beautiful. But it's not enough. So this was chapter 3 of the Blueprint for a Successful Business Makeover. This was video number 3 out of the series of 8 videos about the Blueprint for a Successful Business Makeover, which helps business owners to grow to their full business potential.